My name's Stephen Castrisios, filmmaker from Australia. My background was my first feature, The Horseman. So up until now, I've been doing short films and doing a bit of editing here and there and making wedding videos and driving a taxi and, yeah, just been making little movies since I was a teenager out in the bush with a video camera and a couple of VCRs. So slowly building up to making a bigger film with bigger VCRs and a bigger camera, basically. The Horseman is it's a revenge movie. It's about a teenage girl who dies, and the father goes and wants answers, and the answers don't lead to very nice places. So, it's an action movie, and the thing is that there's so many good revenge movies out there. The challenge was to make something that was a bit different. So we tried to make it really realistic, and the main character Christian is he's just an ordinary dad, you know, and it's set in Australia, which doesn't have a big gun culture, so you know, he's not running around with Uzis. He's got a hammer and a crowbar, and that's about it. So that was focusing on the drama. How would a real person go through the motions of investigating a crime that that the police couldn't go to certain areas, and just finding really good actors and getting the script to somewhere where we could get really good actors without, you know, spending, you know, multi-millions of dollars to get them. I sort of had to work backwards because, you know, ever since I left high school, I was always, okay, I'm going to make an El Mariachi type sort of self-funded, low-budget feature, and just kept writing scripts for that in mind. But I kept writing, I'd get to the end of the script and go, no, I really need at least $100 million to make this. And then I'd get to another one and go, no, I need $20 million to make this. And then they kind of got down and down until I was close with one script. And then again, it was just too much, would need too much money to make it. So I wrote The Horseman in 6 weeks with very specific writing around the resources that we had. Okay, we've got a house in the bush, and we've got a caravan park, and we've got a gymnasium, and wrote the story around that. It's hard because the Australian film industry is difficult. There's very much a tall poppy syndrome, especially to genre films. It's very hard to launch a genre film in Australia. You really have to come overseas and get recognition and then take it back. It's difficult because we rely on government funding for so much of it, and so you can imagine you have to get your projects approved by bureaucracies. And so that's where our film was quite different. We had no government government money, and we kept the budget to a level where we could keep control of it ourselves. So there is no way we would have ever gotten this film through the government bodies, because there's just too many crazy scenes in it that people are talking about now, but we would have never gotten it through. Basically, I would fire them up, I'd go up and really start shaking them and slapping them around and yelling at them and firing them up to really get them pumped up. And then we shot with two cameras and just had it really intense, because for me, it's like, you know, you could have the greatest martial arts fighter there and doing all this amazing choreography, but if it's not really high octane performance, you know, their eyes are about to explode, for me it's not as exciting. And because I'm interested in doing things that are more realistic than cartoony, it becomes a very delicate balance, and I sort of have to struggle with it from project to project. And I'm happy with the balance we got in this film, because the violence in it is done fairly realistically and there are consequences, and I don't think, you know, anyone comes out of our film, you know, sort of pumped to go to a bar and pick some fight, but they can still get a satisfying action movie experience out of it as well.